Brace yourself for a wild good time this weekend. The LaGrange Pet Parade returns for its 76th year. Dogs, cats, goldfishes, ferrets, you name it, the event has been bringing people and pets together for generations, even during the pandemic. This year's event will be in person and in pet. Joining us to tell us more about it is Erin Smith, the Executive Director of the LaGrange Pet Parade. Erin, welcome. How are you today?
I'm great. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, Erin, I guess you guys have been back now for 2 years after doing the virtual one, coming back for 76th year. What does this mean to yourself as an organizer and to the community to continue to have this event going year after year?
Yes, the tradition in the neighborhood and the community is huge, and we're so thankful to be back in person. I think, you know, for years and years, we took advantage or, you know, took for granted, excuse me, the opportunity to have an in-person parade. When COVID hit, we had to, you know, everyone says pivot. But we're back in person, and we're thrilled to be, you know, continuing the tradition, 76 years strong this year. It looks like a gorgeous day tomorrow, and we're all really, really excited.
Now, this pet parade is not only something for families to watch and have fun, but it's also something that gives back to the community. How does this parade do that?
Definitely. The majority of our fundraising each year does go towards just putting on another parade. It takes about $50,000 to run the parade each year. But in 2019 and 2020, we were able to provide a service animal to a veteran. And part of that, Canine for Veterans is the nonprofit we use. And part of that program, we can supply medical and food for the life of the dog. So this year we didn't do that. I really needed to make sure I got the lay of the land. This was my first year in the position, so I needed to kind of learn the ropes of the parade. But moving forward in years to come, it is definitely a goal of mine to make sure that we can give back to the community as much as we can and continue the tradition of providing a service animal to those veterans.
Now, last year was the 75th anniversary of the parade. For somebody who might be coming by for the first time, what can they expect from this event?
I would say expect it to be big. I think that there's going to be great energy this year. I think people are going to show up. I think it's just a wonderful day for the community to come together. So if you're someone who's never been to the parade, please come. Please experience it for yourself, because I truly believe you need to see it to believe it. We have 105 entries this year, ranging from nonprofit entries to business sponsors to paid acts like the Jesse White Tumblers. And we have princesses on a float that are going to be out there wowing the crowd. Tommy Hawk is going to be there. It's going to be a really great day and a lovely way to come together as a community and existing or surrounding communities, I should say, just for a day of just forget your worries and enjoy the parade.
This has been an event that here at WGN-TV we know a lot about. Back in the day, it was actually televised on our air back in the 60s, 70s, and the 80s. I guess, what does it mean to be a part of a Chicagoland staple, to have this event be so important to people and be so important to kind of the fabric and especially the start of summer?
Yeah, definitely. It is the kickoff of summer. Growing up in LaGrange Park myself, I know that my friends and I would get so excited for the parade every year. It means a lot to us. I think it definitely puts LaGrange on the map, and it lets people experience, you know, all the wonderful things our town has to offer. Even though the parade is short, I feel like the memories last forever, so they can always remember LaGrange as a great place to come visit for a good time and hopefully really nice hospitality.
Erin, as we always do on here, we want to give you a chance to say anything you wanted to about what to expect from the parade, what you look forward to the parade. What would you like to add about this experience for those people who are returning yet again or maybe coming by for the first time?
I would say we've got amazing Grand Marshals this year, the American Legion Post 1941. They have been our color guard since 1947 when the parade began. So they are going to be honored this year as really kind of just a staple of the parade that most people, you know, they watch, but I don't know if they honor them necessarily as they should every year. So we are making sure they get honored this year. They are our Grand Marshals. And then we have an honorary Grand Marshal. Her name is Dolores Jones. She marched in the first parade when she was 16 years old. So I think it's a really great way to come full circle, have her be honored as she rides down the parade route in her convertible with her daughter. We have Kendall Coyne Schofield. She is an Olympic hockey player. She won a gold medal in the Winter Games. So it's going to be really fun. The Lyons Township hockey team will be directly following her in the parade. So I think for those kids, that's going to be huge. They're going to be in the presence of an Olympic athlete. I think that's going to be great. And then we have Lynn Lacey and April Lacey Hill. They're also our honorary grand marshals, and they won the Community Service Award. So I think definitely more of a small town, local celebrities feel this year for our grand marshals and honorary grand marshals. But again, that's kind of what the parade's all about. Bob Breen and Susan Breen right now are kind of the heart and soul of the parade. Bob's dad started the parade back in 1947 with the Chamber of Commerce. So really, it's such a mom and pop organization that has grown into something so huge. So we're really excited. We hope you come out and watch us.
Should be a lot of fun. Now, here's some information for you to see about the LaGrange Pet Parade. It is Saturday, June 4th, starts at 9:30 a.m. We'll step off at LaGrange Road and Cosset Avenue. Erin Smith, the executive director of the Pet Parade, joining us here today on WGN News Now to talk about it. Erin, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much. We'll see you all at the parade.